In this video, we continue our discussion on the charge carrier concentrations. In the previous video, you have been introduced to the density of states function, the Fermi-Dirac distribution function, and the Fermi energy level. We will now use these parameters to determine the charge carrier concentrations in thermal equilibrium. Let's recap. First, we discussed the Venn diagram, with its well-defined bands for the electron valence energies, conduction electron energies, and band gap, where there are no energy states that an electron can occupy. Then we define the density of states function. This function is material dependent. The density of states function, therefore, tells you the number of energy states at a certain energy level that are available for an electron to occupy. As you can see in this figure, in high-purity intrinsic semiconductor materials, there are no energy states available for an electron to occupy in the band gap. In the next step, we looked at the occupation of these energy states. For this, we introduced the Fermi-Dirac distribution function, also often called occupation function. This distribution function gives the probability that a certain energy state is occupied at a certain temperature. The Fermi-Dirac distribution function is a general rule applicable to electrons in all kinds of systems. Now the last step is to determine the charge carrier densities in conduction and valence bands. This is what the profile of the occupied states looks like. On the top, we can see the occupation of the conduction band states, and on the bottom, we see the occupation of the valence band states. So how did we get these profiles? Here we see our profiles of occupied conduction and valence energy states. The actual number of electrons occupying a certain energy level, denoted as n, is equal to the product of the number of available states, G, and the probability that a certain state is occupied, F. As we discussed, the probability of an electron occupying an energy level above the Fermi level increases with increasing temperature. However, there are no available states in the band gap. No electrons will occupy an energy level in the band gap. If the temperature starts to increase from the 0 Kelvin, the probability of an electron occupying an energy state in the conduction band will become greater than 0. This is already the case at room temperature. The density of states function is greater than 0 also for energy levels in the conduction band. Consequently, at room temperature, some electrons occupy energy levels in the conduction band. If we want to know the total amount of mobile electrons, we just have to integrate this product from the conduction band edge throughout the band. A similar equation is used for the number of holes in the valence band. However, remember that holes are simply the missing electrons at given states in the valence band. Therefore, we have to multiply the density of allowed states by 1 minus the occupation function to find out which states are unoccupied. Again, we can integrate this product to obtain the total number of holes in the valence band. If we use the Boltzmann approximations, we can calculate these concentrations. For electrons in the conduction band, we get this expression, and for holes in the valence band, we get this expression. I won't go into the full calculation, as you can find it in the textbook. There are 2 new parameters in the equations for carrier concentrations, Nc and Nv. We call these parameters effective densities of conduction and valence band states, respectively. As you can notice, they are different from each other, since the effective mass of electrons is different from the effective mass of holes. Now we get to an important property of semiconductors, the intrinsic carrier concentration, or Ni. Ni squared is equal to the product of N, the concentration of electrons occupying states in the conduction band, and P, the concentration of holes occupying states in the valence band. This product can be calculated as follows. In the simplified expression, we can see that Ni is just dependent on the band gap, temperature, and effective densities of states. In a fully intrinsic semiconductor, since N and P are equal, they are both equal to Ni. For crystalline silicon at 300 Kelvin, Ni is equal to 10 to the power of 10 per cubic centimeter. We will use this value in many equations to come, so make sure to note it down. This graph shows the temperature dependence of charge carrier concentrations in intrinsic silicon. It can be expected that with increasing temperature, more electrons are excited from the valence into the conduction band, since more thermal energy is available. This explains the increasing Ni. With this lecture, you have learned how to determine the concentration of charge carriers within a semiconductor. However, this method is only valid for intrinsic semiconductors in thermal equilibrium. In the following videos, we will first see how the concentration of carriers can be manipulated by doping the material. Afterwards, we will move our analysis to a non-equilibrium situation.